Well, sir, I have never seen anything like what you did back there. A resourceful man like yourself could easily help the people.
My goal is to take Washington down. The rest is none of my concern.
We'll never defeat Washington without the people of New York behind us.
And what do they want?
Well, they're starving. We will win their support if we feed them. However, all the food is controlled by John Fitzwilliams. He is the most corrupt official in a city filled with corruption.
Bring him to me, and I will track him to his stores of food.
There's Fitzwilliams. You won't find a worse bloodsucker this side of the Atlantic. He sells the food at inflated prices and skims the extra for himself.
I do not care about him. We only care about getting people something to eat. Eventually, he'll lead me to his hoard.
Take them all.
under Washington's nose.
Oh, don't you worry. The king gets a cut of every carrot and turnip, all right.
You think Washington's part of this?
What I do with an innocent babe.
You. Yes, you.
I wasn't doing nothing.
Thomas Jefferson needs someone to get this cart of food to hungry people.
To sell it?
Give it.
Free food for hungry folks. You're a man, friend.
Get some friends. We will take as many cartloads as we can.
Right there! Bluecoats! Up there! Come back!
sure I was gonna make it out alive, but goddamn, it's the most fun I've had all week. Thomas Jefferson, people! This here food is thanks to Mr. Thomas Jefferson!
Thomas Jefferson!
Just a few carrots, and he has won their loyalty. What was that?
My friend Paul Revere disappeared 3 days ago. This soldier just confirmed the disappearance of his wife and son as well.
I am sorry.
Revere was an able and valuable man. He was endeavoring to loosen the blue coat grip on the city. Neighborhood by neighborhood, he was winning the people's trust and support.
I will take up Revere's work to help rally the city. If the citizens fight for us, we will replace Washington with a new leader.
This country must be led by the people.
great bounty we enjoy in this country is due to the beneficent...
Tell the truth, damn it!
What? Washington is giving a speech. We may be able to get an idea.
Citizens of the United States, I come before you, a humble man. As I look out upon this vast land, I see each of you suffering. Yes, suffering and striving for a better life, a better future, a better America. Each one of you sacrificing, slaving for this great country, for freedom. And I humbly say to you, your sacrifices inspire me. They shall not be in vain. I know this life is difficult. The ravages of war, food shortages, crime, the burdens caused by Jefferson's seditious murderers. But we have a greater purpose that will unite us and lift us above these trifling troubles. For us, the obliteration of these rebels will be but a foretaste of the feast to come. Citizens, as I stand here, I feel the 4 million hearts of our nation beating within my breast. Today, I announce the great project of this nation. We are mastering vast armies. We are fashioning powerful armadas. We shall soon march upon our great dark enemy, England! We shall invade her shores and irrigate her fields with blood. English bones shall provide grist for our mills, and her people shall become our slaves. Each of you shall profit from the sweat of their labors. Our nation shall rise to its proper place as the greatest of all, the most sovereign kingdom, the United States of America!
Pyramid. Donate your silver candlesticks and other items of value. The splendor of the new palace will reflect glory on us all. Anyone refusing to donate will be flogged.
Tell the truth, damn it.
The king won't protect you. He's using you. Rise up against him. giving thanks to our king? Today is a day of...
Tell the truth, damn it.
King Washington will bring us glory. King Washington.
Tell the truth, damn it.
For liberty!